Dear students, last class we talked about the difference between spoken and written language. It was a preparatory talk for the language of emails. Today we are going to discuss about the language of emails. Emails are one of the most widely used forms of communication, taking over from older, slower methods of conveying messages like sending a fax or writing a letter. Email is highly effective. It only needs an internet connection to work, and the messages are easily archived and searched through, making it a popular tool for companies. Although email shouldn't be used as a replacement for all face-to-face contact, it can serve many functions within a business, reaching people that are in the local area and allowing files to be shared easily. The language you use in professional emails will likely be different to what you would use in personal communications. When using email for professional purposes, you should use formal phrases, avoid slang, and ensure there aren't any grammatical errors. It can be difficult to differentiate between a professional and a more casual style of email writing, especially when English isn't your first language. There are some different phrases, both formal and informal, you can learn that will help you to write the most suitable type of emails. The first one is greetings. It's important to think about the correct way to address the person you are emailing. The following phrases are suitable for addressing someone formally: Dear Sir or Madam, Dear Mr. or Miss Jones, to whom it may concern. First names are not usually used in these kinds of emails, and you can use the following to address someone outside of work or even a colleague that you know well. Hi Alfred, hello Eleanor, dear Jasmine. The next one is reason for writing. It's important to get your message across properly. Think about your reader and how you would like them to respond to what you are writing. Use the following phrases to formally illustrate the reason you are writing. I'm writing to ask for further information about. I'm writing regarding the meeting we have arranged. I'm writing with regard to the complaint you made. With reference to our conversation this morning, I would like to let you know. Use this informal phrase for more casual exchange. Just a quick question. I was wondering if I wanted to let you know that. The next one is making a request. Most of the time, especially in a business context, you will need to make requests or ask for information in your emails. It's important to be polite when you are emailing to ask for a request formally. Could you please let me know if you are available? I would appreciate it if you could send me the document. Could we arrange a meeting later? Please let me know if this will be possible. If you are writing to a friend, you can use informal phrases. I was just wondering if you were around later. Would you mind coming earlier? Can you call me back ASAP? Then the next one is ending. To end an email properly, you need to finish with the appropriate sign-off. These closing phrases are suitable for ending formal emails. Yours sincerely, yours faithfully, kind regard, best wishes. These casual phrases are suitable for ending emails with people you are more comfortable with. Thanks, take care, love. So, in today's class, we discussed about things you have to take care of, or the language you have to pick up while you are making a greeting, or reason for writing, or making a request, and while ending an email. So that's all. Thank you.